Imagine being outdoors this summer. Add some friends. And an adult leader. You're on a mission. A mission to observe the natural world and solve mysteries.
What kind of bird was that?
Where do birds go in a thunderstorm?
I wonder, how fast can a hawk fly?
Are all the stripes the same pattern? How many monarch eggs can we find?
How do you tell a male from a female?
Now, imagine youth groups like yours scattered all over. The adult leaders have been trained by scientists at the University of Minnesota Extension. In their training, the adult leaders learn how to listen to your questions and to collaborate with you on science investigations. Because birds see more colors than people, will they eat food of one color more than another?
Are there more birds on the island or on the lagoon?
Do you think we're not finding many monarchs because it's so dry this year?
The adult leaders ask questions right along with you. They show you techniques of observing, measuring things, and how to report what you've learned. They teach you how to become a scientist in the field. When you're ready for a bigger challenge, your adult leader helps guide your team towards a question you can answer by doing research.
Does a drought affect monarch densities in the wild?
You write your hypotheses.
Drought will decrease monarch densities in the wild. Drought will have no effect on monarch densities in the wild.
Plan your investigation. Collect data. Analyze and interpret the data. Reach your conclusions.
The drought in Wisconsin seems to affect the density of monarch caterpillars.
And present your findings with your friends and other scientists. And when you're done, you go your separate ways at the end of summer, knowing that you are part of a bigger picture of science. You become part of a growing movement of citizen scientists all over the world. You answered your own question and became a scientist.
How cool is that?